Honeybees are remarkable organisms, and of course, lots of people want to keep honeybees. I've been keeping bees myself for many decades, and I enjoy every moment of it. But it is important to know that beekeeping is not for everyone. And so in this video, we're going to go over a short list of things you really need to consider before you decide to keep bees. The first thing I'll mention is simply ask the question, are you allergic to bees? There's a small percentage of people around the world who have a true allergy to bees, and that makes beekeeping not safe for them. Because the reality of beekeeping is you are going to get stung if you keep bees. For those folks who are not allergic to bees, you may say, well, maybe I'm not allergic, that will be okay. But you need to also remember, bee stings hurt, and some people don't like the pain associated with getting stung. It's also important to remember that you can't keep bees everywhere, depending on where you are. There's a lot of rules and regulations associated with keeping bees in various municipalities around the world. So you'll need to check with your local regulations just to make sure that you're even allowed to keep bees in the area that you like to keep bees. It's also very important to know that beekeeping is a significant time commitment. A lot of folks think that they can just put their bees in their backyard and the bees take care of themselves, and that's simply not the case. If you keep just a single honeybee colony, you're probably going to be working at least 1 hour a week through the production season with that one colony. And in as much as beekeeping is a time commitment, it's also a financial commitment. The entry point for beekeeping is somewhat high. Even if you're starting with just one colony, it can cost more than $1,000 once you buy the associated equipment, the protective equipment, the colony, and the bees themselves. Beekeeping is a very big learning curve. Again, a lot of people assume that they can just put bees in their backyards and the bees will collect all the honey that they want, but that's really not true. Beekeeping is animal husbandry. Honeybee colonies are a lot like livestock. If you put bees in your backyard or in an apiary, you have an ethical obligation to do what's necessary to ensure that the bees are healthy and productive. So that takes time and it takes commitment to ensure that you're taking care of the bees in the best way possible. And there's a lot of knowledge that you need to gain before you can be able to do that comfortably and also appropriately. When keeping bees, you have to think a lot about the placement of colonies. And not every site can support bees appropriately. Bees have a very high demand for nectar and pollen resources available in the environment. And of course, nectar and pollen come from flowers, so folks will see flowers in the environment and say, of course these areas can support my bees. But not every flower and not every plant species can produce the nectar and pollen that bees need. So maybe you have limited resources in the areas you want to keep bees. Bees also have a very high demand for water. And if they're not getting water from someplace nearby, you can bet that they're flying to your neighbor's pools, your neighbor's bird baths, and collecting water there. And for that matter, just simply having bees in an area brings a lot of anxiety to people. Maybe you're excited about keeping bees, but maybe your neighbors aren't so excited that you now have a colony in your backyard. And depending on the size of your yard, you may not be able to support a lot of colonies because you may have animals or small children or visitors a lot to that yard, and bees can pose a sting threat to those individuals. Let's revisit this idea about honeybees as livestock. It takes effort to keep them alive. Bees get sick and you're going to have to work to stop that or remedy it. It appeals to a lot of people, right? You're almost a veterinarian looking at your bees and diagnosing their problems, but you have to be able to recognize those problems and then take appropriate steps to make sure the bees come out of those issues and are healthy and productive. And most people really think that bees live forever, but that's simply not the case. You can have colonies with lots of turnover of honeybees in the nest dying all the time, and you don't notice it, so you think things are going well. But one thing that bee colonies do is that they can die, and a lot of people are not ready for that first time that they lose their colony, and it can be quite heartbreaking. So you have to prepare yourself for the fact that this is a living colony that can have a life expectancy depending on what it's encountering in the environment. And not to scare you away from beekeeping, but beekeeping is work. You have to work colonies in hot weather, in cool weather, sometimes at night, sometimes on weekends. The boxes can be heavy, and all of that's happening while you've got insects that sometimes want to defend their nests and you are in the line of fire. So make no mistake, beekeeping is actual effort. You have to do things to ensure your colonies are healthy and productive. I always recommend when getting into beekeeping, you have to temper your expectations. A lot of people getting into beekeeping really have these visions that they're going to have this colony that's overflowing with honey. You're going to have fresh honey on your table every morning, and that's simply not the case. It takes work And you need to know that it's going to take a few years of learning how to keep bees before you're even comfortable knowing if your bees are thriving in the environment that you've placed them. A lot of people really try to get into beekeeping from the save the bees perspective. They've heard that colony populations are dwindling, and they want to do what they can to ensure that honeybee populations are healthy and sustainable for all of the ecosystem and agricultural services they provide. But it is important to know that honeybees are not native everywhere, right? I'm here in the United States. Honeybees aren't native. So if you're interested in getting into beekeeping simply for the purpose of helping the bees, it might actually be better served for you ensuring that your native bee populations are healthy. So what do I recommend if you decide through everything that I've just shared with you that you still want to keep bees? Well, there absolutely is no substitute for joining a local bee club and finding a beekeeping mentor. In fact, my mentor over 30 years ago took me aside and wouldn't let me get my first colony until he spent a year working with me when I read about bees and worked his bees with him. And I think that's really good advice. If you're interested in getting bees, don't just get them. Work with a beekeeper, spend some time with them, see the work involved, the cost involved, the time commitment involved, get stung a time or two, and see if it's right for you. If it turns out to be right for you, it can be a very rewarding business and hobby, but it's also okay if beekeeping isn't right for you.